Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will see how to fix high disk usage or 100% disk usage in Windows 11 operating system. So let's get started. As you can see that in the task manager, I have one disk that is having active time 100% and it is having 100% disk usage all the time. Since you are watching this video, you might have the same case on your system as well. And let's see the solutions you can try. Let's start with our solution number one. Simply right click on the start button and select run. In run window, type services.msc and click OK. In the services window, scroll down until you found sys main service. If the service is already running, just do a double click on it and in the properties sheet, click on the stop button. Now the service will be stopped and then you can set its startup type to disabled. Then click apply followed by OK. Once this service is disabled, monitor the disk usage in task manager and it should now be reduced from 100% to some lesser value. Up next, solution number two. In the solution number two, you can simply right click on the start button and select task manager. When the task manager opens, go to startup apps. There you will see the list of startup apps on your system. Here you can disable the unnecessary apps which you do not need at the time of starting your system, because these apps, when system is started, they contribute to delay the system logon process, and once the system is started, they keep contributing to your high disk usage problem. So disabling the irrelevant apps which you do not use on your system can help you to resolve this issue a bit and reduce your last BIOS time. Then we have solution number three. In this case, I suggest to thoroughly scan your system with Windows Security or the third party antivirus software you are using. By default, Windows 11 comes with Windows Security. So I am showing the steps for Windows Security. You can open Windows Security using search or clicking on its icon present on the taskbar. Once Windows Security opens, go to Virus and Threat Protection. Here under Virus and Threat Protection updates, make sure that you have latest updates installed. In case if the updates are older, you can install latest updates by clicking on Protection Updates and then click on Check for Updates. Now go back to the Virus and Threat Protection screen and here you can perform a quick scan of your system in order to check your system thoroughly for any malware or virus, because they can also contribute to high disk usage problem. Also, from here you can click on Scan Options and you can select a full scan as well if it is required. You can perform the similar quick scan or full scan from your third party antivirus as well. And once you ensure that your system is not infected, you can go to the next solution. In the solution number four, we will do a right click on the start button and select settings. When the settings app opens, under accounts, go to sign in options. Scroll down until you found additional settings. There you will be able to find automatically save my restartable apps and restart them when I sign back in option. If this option is turned on by default, simply turn it off and close the settings app. Up next, we have solution number five. Simply click on the search icon present on the taskbar. In the search, type defrag and from search results, select defragment and optimize drives. Click on the open. Once the optimized drives window is there, click on change settings. Then under optimization schedule, uncheck the option run on a schedule recommended option and click OK. And then close this window. Then we have solution number six. Right click on the start button and select run. In run window, type sysdm.cpl and click OK or press the enter key. Once the system properties window appears, click on advanced. Then under performance, click on settings Now you are in the performance options window. Switch to advanced tab and under virtual memory, click on change. Then under virtual memory, uncheck the option automatically manage paging file size for all drives. Then here you have to select custom size and then you can type in the initial size and maximum size. You can take the reference of total paging size mentioned below, and this totally depends upon the RAM installed on your system. Click OK, and finally, if you are asked to restart your system to make the changes effective, do that and click on the restart now button. Up next, we have solution number 7. Right click on the start button and select device manager. Once the device manager window opens, expand IDE ATA/ATA PI controllers, and here you will be able to locate standard SATA ASCI controller. Just double click on it to access its properties. Switch to driver tab, and here you have the driver details button. Just click on it. Now in the next window, if you see store ahci.sys as your driver, then you can proceed with the next steps I will share in this solution. In case if it has any different value, then you can skip this solution. Now go to the details tab in the standard SATA AHCI controller properties. Click on the property drop down and select device instance path. Now copy the value by doing a right click and select copy. Now right click on the start button and select run. In run window, type REGEDIT and click OK. Click yes in the user account control confirmation prompt. Once registry editor window opens, you have to go to H key local machine, system, current control set, ENUM, then go to PCI, expand this registry key, then you have to match the value in the property sheet under device instance path property to the registry subkey next to PCI. So upon looking carefully in the registry window, I was able to find out the exact registry key matching the device instance path, and once I expanded it, I have the subkey with the same value. Here you can see, and then expand device parameters registry subkey, then expand interrupt management registry subkey, and then you will be able to locate the registry subkey named message signaled interrupt properties. In the corresponding right pane, you will be able to locate MSI supported named registry dword. By default, the value data for this registry dword is 1. Just double click on it and set its value data to 0 and close the registry editor and restart your system. After restarting the system, you should be able to see a decrease in the high disk usage on your system. Then we have solution number 8. Click on the search icon present on your taskbar and type CMD. From the search results, select command prompt and then click run as administrator. Click yes in the user account control confirmation prompt. Once the command prompt window opens, type this command or paste it from the video description and press the enter key. Make sure you substitute the exact system root drive in this command, and that drive should be where Windows is installed, for example the C drive. Once you execute this command, you would be asked, check this cannot run because the volume is in use by another process. Would you like to schedule it for next restart? Simply type Y and press the enter key. And now the check disk is scheduled for the next restart. You can now restart your system and disk check will be automatically performed to identify if there are any bad sectors available on your drive, and Windows may attempt to repair them as well. Solution number 9. Simply right click on the start button and select run in run window, type services.msc and click OK. Once the services window opens, scroll down and locate connected user experiences and telemetry service. By default, this service may be running and having automatic status. All you need to do is just double click on it and click on stop button to manually stop the service and set its startup type to disabled. And once you do that, simply restart your system and monitor the disk usage on your system. And now we come to the last solution for this video guide. High disk usage problem would be there if you are using HDD and not the SSD. We have seen in many cases HDD mostly contributing to high disk usage problem on Windows 11. And if you consider to switch to SSD, you have relatively less disk usage on these drives. So in this solution, I would suggest to switch to SSD in case if previous solutions didn't work and if you have HDD. After doing these suggestions, hopefully the 100% disk usage problem should be resolved on your system and the disk usage should be now lowered down. If you are still facing the problem, do let me know your comments. I'll be happy to help you. And that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.